Let's think about the market for real estate in a given city. So here on the vertical axis, I have plotted rent in terms of dollars per square foot per month. Here on the horizontal axis is essentially the quantity of square foot per month available in millions. So this is 1 million, 2 million, 3 million, 4 million, 5 million. Here in blue, we have the demand curve. And you see as the price is high, the demand, one way to view it is that the demand for square footage is low, and as the price is low, the demand for square footage is higher. But what I really want to focus on in this video is viewing the demand curve as the marginal benefit curve. Marginal benefit curve. So when that first incremental square foot that is added to the market, that has a huge marginal benefit. People were desperate to get an apartment, to get some place where they could rent and they could live. So it has a huge marginal benefit. And then the marginal benefit for every incremental square foot starts to go down. Likewise, we can look at the supply curve. And we're going to look at this as the marginal cost curve. So the marginal cost of that very first incremental square foot for the suppliers, for the landlords in the city, is $1 per square foot. So one way to think about it, that very first square foot, we don't know what its price would have been, but let's say that its price was at $3, if it was, and I'm just making that up. In that reality, if that very first square foot's price was at $3, there's definitely an incentive for someone to make that first square foot because their marginal cost is only a dollar, and they could rent it out at $3 per month. And there's definitely an incentive for someone to rent it. The marginal benefit is $4, and they just have to pay $3 for it. So it could be rented out for anywhere, or it would exist, or this kind of transaction would happen as long as its price was between $1 and $4. But you can imagine, based on how this is drawn, where the actual equilibrium price is. The suppliers will keep adding more and more square foot as long as they can actually rent it out, all the way until the point that the marginal benefit is equal to the marginal cost. So right over here, marginal benefit is equal to marginal cost. It wouldn't make sense for suppliers to produce an incremental square foot right over here. If they produce an incremental square foot, their marginal cost has gone beyond $3, while the marginal benefit is below $3. No one is going to rent that thing out. So we reach an equilibrium at 2 million, we reach an equilibrium point at 2 million square feet per month on the market. Let me make that line a little bit straighter. 2 million square foot per month on the market, and at a price of $3 per square foot per month. And you can look at the total surplus here. In this equilibrium scenario, we can calculate the consumer surplus. So all of these folks, this first incremental foot, someone was willing to pay $4 per square foot, they only have to pay $3. The next one, a little less than $4, benefit, they only have to pay $3, all the way to this point right over here. So the area of this triangle right over here, this right over here, is the consumer surplus. So that right over here is consumer surplus. And we can calculate it. This is a triangle. I'm assuming actually both the supply and demand curves are lines. So let's see, this has a height of 1, and it has a base of 2. And so its area is going to be 1 times 2 times 1/2. So that's going to be equal to $1 million. We're multiplying $1 times 2 million times 1/2. So that's going to be $1 million of consumer surplus per month. Let's think about the producer surplus. Well, the producer surplus is going to be this area, right over here. That first incremental foot, it only cost those producers $1, but they're able to sell it for $3. So that's rent it out for $3. And then they will keep producing all the way until they do 2 million square foot. And for all of their square feet, they're able to rent it out for more than it was their cost to produce it. So the area of this triangle is the producer surplus. This is the producer surplus. The producer surplus, and we can calculate that as well. The height right over here is $2. $2 times this width is 2 million square feet per month. 2 times 2 times 1 half is 2. So this is equal to $2 million. So if we were to talk about what the total surplus is, it is $3 million. Now, this equilibrium rent, $3 per square foot per month, is actually quite a lot. For a 1,000 square foot apartment, my last apartment was a two bedroom, two bath apartment. It was about 1,000 square foot. So that means you're going to be paying $3,000 per month for that. So that's pretty high rent. That's the type of rent that you might pay in a city like San Francisco. And let's say people start complaining about it. And so the government says, OK, that rent is not fair. It's too high. We want to introduce some type of price control. We want to introduce rent control. Rent control. And I'm oversimplifying how this works. But just so that we can deal with this model right over here, let's say that the city just sets a ceiling on the price per square foot per month. So let's just say that they set a price ceiling. A price ceiling of $2 per square foot per month. $2 per square foot per square foot. Let me write it this way. $2 per square foot per month. So they set a price ceiling. They set a price ceiling right over here. So given that, what is going to happen? What is going to happen? And what I really want to think about is what is going to be the new consumer surplus and the new producer surplus. And I encourage you to pause the video and try to think about that on your own. Well, let's think about what's going to happen. From the producer's point of view, it doesn't make sense for them to produce more than 1 million units. If they that 1 million square feet per month, or have rent or rent out more than 1 million square feet per month, because that extra square foot above that, its marginal cost is going to be more than what they're going to get. So the producers are just going to stop there. And so the producer surplus is going to be the area of this triangle. Right over here, and let's see, this is $1 times 1 million times 1 half. So this is now a producer surplus, a new producer surplus under the rent control of $500,000, half a million, of $500,000. So we see that the rent control immediately hit the producers pretty hard. The producer surplus has gone down dramatically. Now what about the consumer surplus? So we're talking about 1 million units. So the consumer, or 1 million square foot per month, I should say. So now the new consumer surplus is the area, is this entire area. And so you see that at least for this first incremental 1 million square feet, the consumers have started to win out a little bit. And to figure this out, what the total area is, we just need to figure out what, we could break this up into two sections. We could break this up into two sections. And this is the point, 1 million square feet at $3.50 per square foot per month. This is right over here, the point 3.5. So we could use that to figure out this new area. And actually, let me do it in a different color. And this green area right over here, what is it going to be? Well, the area of this thing right over here is 1 half high, 1 half times 1. Times 1 half. So this is going to be, this right over here is 250K. And we add that to this area right over here, which is 1.5 times 1. $1.50 per square foot per month times 1 million. Did I do that right? Yep. So that's going to be plus this, which is 1.5. million, you add these two together, the total consumer surplus. So the consumer surplus, the total consumer surplus is now 1.75 million. 1.75 million. So the consumer surplus definitely did go up in total because it gained all of this from the producer. But let's think about what has now happened in our society. Or in our city, we the producers definitely don't want to put out as many square foot per rent anymore, and it does look like we have lost some total surplus for our little city here. We have lost out on this entire area, and we can calculate it by looking at what the total surplus was before the rent control and what the total surplus was after the rent control. The total surplus before, So before, the total surplus was the 2 million producer surplus plus the 1 million consumer surplus. So it was 3 million. After, it is the 1.75 million consumer surplus plus the 500,000 producer surplus, which is 2.25 million. And so what we've lost is the difference here, which is $750,000. So this area right over here, and this is per month, this right over here represents the lost total surplus. And this lost total surplus, this $750,000 per month, is referred to as the dead weight loss. So you can debate about rent control, and is it good, is it bad, is it good for this kind of dynamic, who gets what share of the surplus. And this, of course, is an oversimplification of a market and even the way rent control would be instituted. But this is a model for beginning to think about whether, what happens to the total surplus when these types of price controls are instituted.